Welcome to BIMS TV. I'm Dr. Jeanette Davis, also known as Dr. Ocean, and this is BIMS Bites. Today, I'll be biting into marine drug discovery. So we take medicines when we're sick or not feeling well, but have you ever wondered where do medicines and or drugs come from and how are they discovered? And for the purpose of this particular BIMS Bites episode, how is that related to the ocean environment? Well, the short answer to that question is that most of the medicines that we take, the actual chemical structures that make up those medicines can be found in nature. And we call those natural products. In order to really understand that concept, it's important to first understand that medicines are simply just chemical structures. They are chemical compounds. And so on the periodic table, there are several elements, oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, so on. And these elements come together to form a chemical bond and create chemical structures or chemical compounds. And that's what we take when we are taking medicine. So even though it's in a pill or liquid form, it's actually a chemical structure. Now, these chemical structures can be created in a laboratory setting by scientists or isolated in a laboratory setting. But as I mentioned earlier, most of these chemical structures can be found in nature. And with the ocean being the largest and oldest habitat on the planet, it has a lot of potential to harbor these interesting chemical structures. In fact, 90% of our biosphere is in the ocean environment. And that simply means that most of the living organisms that we know of actually do live in the ocean. So the more organisms, the more biodiversity, which also means the more chemicals and the more potential to create these interesting chemical structures that we can use for medicines. So to create a medicine is a really long process, but for today, I'm going to simply talk about the first part of that process in marine drug discovery, which is called bioprospecting. And the way that works is first you go out and collect the sample. And again, the ocean environment is rich in a variety of different organisms. So you target an organism and you go out and collect the sample. And through chemical analysis, you then take that sample and try to identify all of the compounds that are in that particular sample. And once you've identified and isolated all of these different types of compounds, you ask yourself, what disease or infection do I want to test against? And so there are known diseases and known testing methods that you can use on all of these different compounds. So that's called targeted screening. And for an example here, each of these shapes and colors could represent a different type of targeted screening. So the orange line could represent an antiviral assay. So you can take your compound that you isolated and say, does this fight against virus? And if it does, it could have antiviral properties. Or your red triangle, for an example, could represent a test for cancer. And so if your isolated compound works with this particular assay and it shows activity, then you can say that my isolated compound has anti-cancer properties, and so on. So you continue to screen with these known assays. And eventually, if you're lucky, you can then confirm that the compound that you've identified actually does have properties against the particular screening that you've done. So for an example, we can say that we isolated X compound and it has anti-cancer properties. So here's an actual case study of a marine drug discovery event. And this is where it was discovered in Oahu, Hawaii. A sea slug, Alicia rufescens, in its algal diet, Bryopsis, in the early 1990s, a really promising anti-cancer compound called kahalaline F was extracted from both the sea slug and the algal diet. And the interesting thing about this particular story is that later on we discovered that it was actually a marine microbe, meaning an organism that you can't see without a microscope. that lived in the actual bryopsis that the sea slug would then eat and take up to harbor the interesting anti-cancer compound. So in this case, we discovered that it was actually a marine microbe that produced this really interesting compound that was associated with both the sea slug and the algal diet. But this is not unique in the marine environment. There are lots of different marine drugs that have been approved within the marine environment dating back to 1969, where an anti-cancer compound was discovered in a sponge. And then a few years later in that same sponge, an antiviral medicine was discovered. And here are a list of some others. And again, this is just a few examples of a cone snail. And then later on in these other anti-cancer compound cases, it's really interesting because we see in some cases, as in 2007, where we isolated a compound from a sea squirt and later discovered that it was actually a microbe associated with the sea squirt that was producing this interesting anti-cancer compound. And the same thing happened in 2011, where a compound was isolated from a mollusk and later discovered that it was actually a microbe associated with the mollusk that produces this anti-cancer compound. And then also in 2018, recently, a tunicate was discovered to harbor an interesting marine drug. So I hope that you've learned that the ocean is valuable and important, but also a great place and a great resource for marine drug discovery. Feel free to contact me with any questions on my website at www.droocean.science, or you can email me at info@droocean.science, or follow me on Instagram or Twitter at droocean24. Please like, subscribe, and follow us. And thanks for tuning in. And you can follow us at Black and Marine Science. Thank you. Thank you.